Well, welcome back, everybody, to the Figure Kit Garage. Fellow resin heads and kit builders, Brent Krug back with Work in Progress Part 3 on the Typhon Studios Millicent Patrick Tribute Bust. The last video, we had pretty much gotten the skin tones on the hand and the face locked in where we wanted it. And what I decided to do after I finished that video last night was I decided to brush the inside of the collar with the blue that I'm going to paint the rest of her shirt. And it really brings out her skin tone nicely. It's a color called Sapphire Gem from Army Painter, and that's going to be the base coat color for her shirt. And you can see I've already got tape along the edges of the collar. I'm going to mask off pretty much from here up on the coat while I'm painting that blue, because I'm going to have to do some highlights and mist over those to push those back, as well as shadows. And I'll be using a combination of fine line pinstriping tape, which is what this is. It's 1/8 inch pinstriping tape. I bought it off of Amazon. Glad press and seal and liquid latex. And I'll do all the masking off camera. It's going to take me way too long, and filming it would just bore the hell out of everybody, so I'm not going to put you guys through that. So what I'm going to begin with now is I'm going to go ahead and go in and block in the whites of the eyes, as well as getting the eyebrows done and the eyelashes, getting the lips and the teeth done. And I'll do the earrings and the pearl necklace off camera, because I'm going to have to wear magnifiers for that. So let's go ahead and get started with the whites of the eyes. And for that, I'm going to use a combination of Ceramcoat Oyster White and Army Painter Shark White. It's more gray than white, but I'm going to add just a little bit into this oyster white to push it back a little bit. I need to push it back a whole heck of a lot. I didn't break out my vortex mixer for this. Probably should have, but that's all right. One little drop, and we'll see how well that mixes up. Yeah, it's just perfect. It added enough gray to that oyster white to knock that white back some and put more of a gray tone in it. Work just perfectly, because the whites of the eyes are not pure white. They have a more grayish undertone to them. And I'm going to give this new brush I picked up today at Hobby Lobby a try. It's a 3-0 spotter. That should give me enough fine line detail to actually, we'll go in with Lifeline's Natural Lip for the pink under at the bottom of the eyelid and the corner of the eye first. I need very much of that. Mix up better. Yep, perfect. Now the artist colors from Createx go on semi-transparent, so it may take me a few layers to get this done right. If I'm off camera, I apologize. I'm trying to keep this in my view more than anything else, because this is something I do not want to screw up. I And notice I'm only hitting around the bottom eyelid area. I'm going to turn this camera ever so slightly towards me a little bit more so you guys can see better. Apologize for all the sniffling and everything else. I think with it becoming fall out here in California, I'm starting to meet up with Mr. Allergy again, which I hate the hell out of, to be brutally honest. Having sneezing fits all day, so. That's the natural lip pink down at the bottom edge of the eyelid. Get a little bit more on there. The corners of the eye as well. So that's the pink in the lower eyelid. Let that sit for a few minutes. Get a little bit of a reducer into that gray-white mix. Just one drop ought to do it. Which is rather effortless. The drop came out on its own. That'll help this flow just a little bit better. All right, now for this, I'm gonna put on my magnifiers. So I wanna have a really good look at what I'm doing. And the magnifiers that I have, picked these up off of Amazon for about $35. Comes with four different magnifications. Excuse me, five different. 1.2, 1.8, 2.5, 3.5, and 4.5. Usually the most I ever have to use is the 2.5. I've only used the 3.5 once and the 4.5. I'm lucky if I can see anything. So probably just use the I may go with a 3.5 on this. It's a really nice setup though. First time I ever used it, I was working on the Bo-Katan from Blackheart Models, and it really helped me get a lot of good detail in there. And these are all the different switch out lenses. Go with a 3.5 time magnification, and it does have LED lighting, warm yellow and medium. Back in the box. When you don't use these things for a while, they really screw with your eyes. So. Try to keep this in camera as much as I can. It'll take me at least one, maybe two more coats of this into the eye to get it completely solid. And before I even think about painting the sclera and the pupil in, I have to seal this off. God, it really hurts my eyes. But that's one eye blocked in. It looks really good. And maybe one more coat will completely finish that off. Having the reducer mixed in with this paint actually gives that paint better adhesion, and it goes on a lot easier. Yeah, I'm gonna turn this upside down while it's on camera, but I'd rather move the piece than my hand. That's what makes it so difficult to do kits like this sometimes, is so damn big you can barely turn them around. End up having to paint from odd angles. Mixing that reducer in with that really, really makes that go on smooth. Back and work on the other eye. Fix, but it's nothing major. Rinse my brush out real quick and go back at it. It's almost right where I want it. God, these things are really messing with my eyes right now. Damn. Glad I'm not using a four-time magnification. I wouldn't be able to see squat. looking at that magnified, I can see all the skin textures and the freckling and everything that I added in, so I'm really proud of how that skin tone's turned out. Refine the edge of that right eye right at the end. A little bit more dimension to it. Eyes are always the most tedious. Still are sometimes for me. But I've never wanted to use decals or anything like that. And I know there's a lot of people out there that like using the Archer Fine Transfer decals, and it's a damn shame that Archer is, for those of you that don't know, Archer Fine Transfers is shutting down its business after 33 years. And they didn't just do eye decals, they did all kinds of military insignia for every scale of aircraft you can think of, and I remember seeing some of their decals up close, and those guys really knew what the hell they were doing. So, but I remember reading that post, and the guy said he started it when he was in his 40s, and he's now 70 years old, so you can't blame the guy for wanting to move on with his life, but it leaves a hell of a hole for a lot of military and sci-fi modelers with no place to get some of the finest decals that have ever been done for any hobby. Plastic models, resin, vinyl, what have you. It's, you know, big bucket of wind to Archer Fine Transfers for keeping builders happy with decals for over 30 years. And I seriously mean that. So I'm going to take a little airbrush thinner. I got a little white speck on her left eyelid. It needs to be erased. Okay, now that that's settled, I'll go ahead and start blocking in the eyelashes. Should have black in here somewhere. If I don't, I'd be ashamed. I'm gonna be using one small drop of Vallejo Black, mixed with a little bit of reducer. I gotta flip these things out there, making me go blind. If you don't use these things for a while, it really messes with your eyes. So when you're not using them, flip them up and don't ruin your eyesight. this is my last day off, so I'm going to try and get as much done as I can. Next Thursday will be the only day of the week that I work on this, because Friday, Saturday, and Sunday I will be in Victorville at my sister's house doing a big birthday celebration for myself. Virginia, her birthday's coming up on the 26th. My brother-in-law Mario, my niece Kathy, whose birthday was the beginning of, or right before mine in August. So we got one, two, three, four, five birthdays to celebrate, and it's going to be one big damn cake. I can already see it coming. So get as much done on this as I can. I will have at least Thursday to maybe do a little bit of work on this, and that'll be it. Sometimes it's so hard to do this, especially with that left arm glued on. It kind of gets in my way a little bit. Thank you. looks like shit. The right lower eyelid actually curves down more than the left one does. So I have to compensate for that, but I'm not exactly sure how it's going to turn out. Some of this pink over the top of that black. I don't think I did that correctly. If I can. Okay, it looks a little bit better. It's just that right lower eyelid curls down more than the left one does. I'm not sure why. If that was the way it was sculpted, it's kind of throwing me off. But you can actually see it in camera. It actually curls downward. Sorry, folks, these magnifier lenses are killing my eyes. I'll be right back. All right, we're back. Had to do the eyelashes off camera because I ran into a pretty damn big problem that I wasn't accounting for. Unfortunately, the lower right eyelid was sculpted angled outwards more than the left, and trying to paint that and compensate for that was just not paying off, unfortunately. So I painted in both the upper and lower eyelashes as best I could. But you can tell that they look totally different on both the upper and lower. I did the best I could. I'm not sure how to compensate for that. I'm going to have to leave the eyes alone for now until I can figure out a way to beat that. That's really upsetting. But I'll figure out a way to get around it somewhere sooner or later. Excuse me, I needed a drink. Pepsi, not beer. So now I'm going to block in the eyebrows with Pan Pastels Burnt Sienna Extra Dark. I've seen a few people try this trick before, and I did it on the McCready and the Christopher Reeve, and it actually works out really well. Gives a much softer look to the eyebrows overall. In case I make any mistakes, wonderful kneadable eraser removes any blemishes that I might get on the skin. So keep that in mind if you use pastels. Get yourself a good kneadable eraser, because it will erase any errors that you make with pastels. Give this one a try. This looks a little bit smaller. Try to keep that on camera, I apologize. It's not coordinated tonight for some reason. As you can see, it gives a nice natural soft tone to the eyebrow overall. Try to match the shape right here at the end. Good. I'm going for the other one. Okay. That's the one thing about pen pastels. Any eraser you use will erase any mistakes that you make on any media whatsoever, be it canvas, paper, or whatnot. Actually, not too damn bad. Sorry, I'm not keeping this in camera. I need to turn the camera angle a little bit. There we go. On the left hand side and darken that down. Now we have neatly rendered eyebrows with pan pastels. It's a much softer look than painting them in with dark brown paint. And I do like the way the technique works out in the end. It looks really good. It looks very natural. And I'm going to go with the way I have the eyelashes. That's probably not going to look very good in the end, but I can't really modify her eyes anymore to balance those out. I'm at an absolute loss on it, why I can't get that. So I'm going to flat coat the eyebrows, and we'll come back and we'll get the lips and the teeth painted in. Alright, we're back. Sealed off her eyebrows and eyelashes and everything. So now I'm going to go in with this natural lip and I'm going to layer that on. Very lightly. It's thinned down, but it's not quite a wash. So I'm going to layer Illustration Blood Red over the top of her lips for the lipstick. Very lightly as well. It's a nice deep reddish tone, it'll look really good. Thank you. upside down. I do apologize if I sound frustrated about the eyelashes. It's just that kind of hard to compensate for something when it's that uneven. And tried my best to make it look good. So I know it's hard for sculptors to get everything perfectly symmetrical on both sides, so I can't really, I'm not a sculptor in any capacity, so you know, I'm not gonna throw stones in glass, or throw boulders in glass houses, I should say, so I'll just leave it at that. Okay, so now the lips are blocked in. I go right up to the edge and then back it off just a little bit. It's been a while since I've used the coagulated crimson, then I'm gonna go in with I'll probably mix a little bit of the natural lip in with that just to lighten that up. Dark. Yeah, that's a really dark red tone. Thin that down just a little. Should flow a lot better. I just use regular airbrush thinner instead of reducer. It'll also go on a little bit more transparent. just fine. Apologize for the camera angle again. I had to readjust. Now I have the lips blocked in with the blood red tone. It's a really nice looking color. So now I'm going to take the natural lip and mix one drop in there with it. That up considerably. Let's get these paints out of my way. I'm gonna have to go back to my magnifiers. So it's going to be screwed up after this is over with. out this coagulated crimson one more time, or blood red one more time. Just wanted a better edge on the outside left of the lip. Seemed just a little bit off, so I went back in and redid it. Stir this mix up one more time. That's a nice highlight. I like that a lot. It has a nice reddish pink tone to it. Gives a really beautiful highlight on the lower lip. I like the way that looks. Do just barely enough on that upper lip. Not going to do the eyes on this video. What I'm going to wind up doing after I get the teeth done, we'll go ahead and start painting the shirt. Again, re-detailing the lips with the blood red. Just enough contrast in that pink highlight. God, that looks really beautiful. So there we have the lips painted. Nice pinkish red highlight. Went back in and detailed the wrinkles in the lips with the blood red. The way that came out, that looks really nice. All right, so now I'm gonna set this off to the side. I'm gonna have to scrub this thing out later. I need a new palette, and I'm gonna break out the Folk Art Vintage White. It's more of a kind of a off yellowish white, not really heavy yellow. I'm gonna go ahead and let this dry out. is a pure white on her teeth. This wouldn't look right. And because folk art is more medium than pigment, in a lot of cases, I'll probably have to lay down more than one coat on her teeth, but that's all right. Beautiful smile. Maybe one more coat will do that. Doesn't look too bad. Yeah, one more coat on those teeth ought to be okay. Smaller brush and do a lot better detail. not too bad. Probably get a little bit more definition in between those teeth. Slight wash of Agrax Earthshade will define each of the teeth more. Still got purple paint in this brush from when I painted She-Hulk. Damn. And it could very well ruin that brush, and I'm not liking that at all. Beautiful. I'm very happy with how it's turning out. Now the lips are painted in. That highlight on her lips is very subtle. You have to get close in on it to even notice it, but it looks really, really good. Teeth dry, come back in and do one more layer. All right, we're back. Got the teeth painted in. I'll do a little bit more detailing on those later. For right now, I'm going to mist this over with Krylon matte, let it dry, and then what I'm going to do off camera is I'm going to go ahead and mask off the head and the neck and inside the collar with Silly Putty and Glad Press and Seal. And then go around the outer edges of the jacket, the sleeves, with press and seal and liquid latex. And down here inside the coat, so I don't get a whole lot of blue overspray. But we're going to concentrate on getting the shirt painted next. So it's going to be a few minutes before I get all that done. Just hang tight. We'll be right back.